virtually is your second question, where where someone else takes up the camera and you tell him exactly what to do. It's like giving, it's like giving your car to a person who doesn't know how to drive. First gear में डालो,
संभाल के चलाना,
क्लच रिलीज करो, संभाल के, फिर राइट साइड में सिग्नल आ रहा है, राइट मोड़ना है अंदर से.
I would not do that.
You're gonna have a mishap, surely, no two ways about that. So that is something that I would never suggest anyone to do. You know, you may need to cut down on a guest or two guests or three, depending on your requirements for your wedding film and pictures. But having a photographer there is it is very important. He is the master of his camera. He knows what he's got to do. He's going to do the right thing when he's there. Telling him virtually to do something, there could be a lag. I mean, for the lag, the person who's behind the camera may not know so much about the camera. He may know about the camera. He may know how to use it as well. But he's not going to be able to get the same creativity that the photographer is going to bring about in the pictures. So definitely getting the photographer onto the scene is imperative. Whether it be one or two or three, depending on the requirements. A photographer is minimum. And if you're doing film, you're making a film out of the wedding, well, then I think you need to have at least two cinematographers there just to ensure that you can get the right cuts, you can get the right angles, you can... Then, you know, that's the point of time he can use the right equipment also. Today, we're all about DSLRs. We're using mirrorless cameras. So all these cameras are best with their, you know, with the lenses that we use, which are block lenses and which have, you know, which do not have the tele wide. You don't have these cameras, the lenses which are going from a tele shot to a wide shot. A wide lens would be used with one camera and the other one would be using a tele lens or a zoom lens. These two, when they're taken on board onto the editing table, the editor can do justice by utilizing both the footages and creating a film. The moment you're giving one cameraman the opportunity to shoot the entire film, he's going to be able to use only one of the two, which is going to be a wide angle shot. Because he has to try and grab everything and not miss out the moment. He will not be able to bring creativity. So we are going back into the days when we used to have those old films, those old movies which hardly anybody used to literally watch because they used to be 3PR films, and they used to be lack the creativity of the shots, as well as you yet have the music, you yet have the editing skills, you yet have the technology today to help us, but you do not have the footage to utilize it because you have one camera footage only. So you want to have at least two camera footages to put it together by the editor well.
Yeah, and also photographs are all about memories. They are the only piece of golden moment that you have of your wedding. You know, so I think they should invest. Everyone should invest in a couple of two photographers for at least
one photographer would be okay, and two videos in a small intimate wedding at home. That should be the minimum requirement at home. But the moment you're taking it out to another location, or you know, two people coming from two different places, like the bridegroom coming from her hotel and the groom coming from his hotel, then you need to split up two teams as well, because you need one camera with the bride, one camera with the groom, and then both of them assemble at one place. So the logistical part of it totally depends on the number of people that are going to be present at the number of photographers and cinematographers that are going to be present at the wedding. So if it's at home, everybody getting ready at home and then moving into the wedding, one each is just, you know, about manageable, because you know the space is small and you got too many people there already. But the moment taking it out to another location and they're getting ready from different zones and getting into the same mandap, well, then then yes, you need a slightly larger team. You need to double up the team.
Have you managed to get any of these photo shoots during the lockdown? In a lockdown scenario?
No.
But you're open to do that?
Well, absolutely. We're totally open to that. Now, I think the lockdown is something which is not there. We're not looking at a lockdown anymore. I think from the 31st, we're actually looking at a restriction in terms of number of people. It's not a lockdown anymore after that. I think probably there could be a curfew timing get being maintained of 7 o'clock, or it may, you know, push on to 8 or 9 o'clock, whatever happens, that's, you know, your guess is as good as mine where that is concerned. But but yes, once the post 31st, I think things will change. You know, we're already seeing a fact of things opening up slow and steady. There are cities like Bombay which are really bad at this point of time. But I think what the government is looking at doing is properly opening all these places slowly and steadily so that, you know, at least the economics start working back for people.
To roll, the economy starts to roll, okay.
That's
the
thing for everybody. We're all hoping for that as well, to be honest, you know, that the economy starts and people stay safe by understanding their responsibilities and, you know, wearing their masks and, you know, being out in these places. So that's another worry that I have. Imagine doing a shoot with of a wedding with everybody wearing a mask. You know, that's one. It's like a fearful thought. I mean, it's like a nightmare for me, because you want to see the smiles, you want to see the expressions, you want to see the laugh, you want to see that moment when you know, someone's looking into, you know, with, you know, the couple is looking at one of, you know, at each other and giving a laugh or a burst of laugh or a smile, and that's not going to be happening. That's not going to be behind the curtain, literally. So you're going to miss out on these kind of moments, although there may be other, you know, things that would be available to capture. But but I think the charm of getting those candid moments, it's going to be a little more difficult if they're going to be hidden behind the mask, to be honest.
Okay. One more question pertaining to the photography during lockdown. What do you think about drone photography during this time? You think that can be used as the drone photography? A lot of photographers are talking about drone photography. Can that be a replacement for a real photographer to capture moments during limited members for a wedding?
Well, there are. I wouldn't say it's the only thing that one can do. That can be addition.
Okay.
It can't be the only way that a wedding photography has to be done, because drones, first things first, are not permissible legally in our country. There are restrictions. You have to get special permission, which again is a question mark whether, you know, it'll be there or not, the permission. Secondly, it could be a dangerous thing to get a drone as low as someone's face, like a eye shot.
Eye contact.
You know, someone eye contact and someone moves around and hits it or something like that. You know, it could be dangerous. Those blades spin at a very fast pace, and it could hurt somebody, and it could really be bad. So you don't want to get into a situation like that. I think drone photography is an addition. You cannot take it as the first photographer. It could be a third eye. I would rather have two ground eyes rather than having one eye in the sky. You know, I'd rather have two photographers shooting on different angles, rather than having one angle in the sky, because the only thing we're going to get from the sky is people's head. You're going to get a little bit, you know, two shots, three shots, but everybody wants to see faces, right? You don't want to just see the top of your
head.
So, well, it could be an addition, not the main photographer.
One question is are there any do-it-yourself ideas pertaining to lightning angles or backgrounds that people could get into for better quality photographs?
Well, as I was saying earlier, a good photograph is like a like meeting all the circles, you know, points to create a circle. So it's all about the couple, their expressions, their what they wear, the location, the background, the lighting, the angle of the photographer, the technical aspects of doing that shot. And and lightning is one of the most important elements to create the circle. So yes, lighting is very, very crucial. That's why we're talking about the golden hour, which is fantastic at that point in time. But even after that, if you have to do night shots, you have to do a night wedding, you have to play with light. You have to have some kind of lighting that would enhance the look of the place. You cannot shoot in complete darkness. What the eye can see, the camera can see. So if you can't see in pitch darkness, the camera will not see in pitch darkness. You need some light. Whatever the eye will see, the camera will record the same.
Okay. So that's about a lot of questions. I would like to take some questions from the audiences who've been watching us live. You know, so there was somebody who was asking us. I'm sorry, we've come way ahead of our this thing. Is it necessary to take a tour of the venue and understand the lighting from a photographer for an event?
Very, very important.
Mm-hmm.
I think you can do without it also. It's not that you can't. But if you mm-hmm. go to the venue and mm-hmm. you understand the venue a couple of days prior mm-hmm. to the wedding,
mm-hmm.
it
mm-hmm.
just helps you to understand where what is going to happen. How is mm-hmm. the flow going to take place? If the bride is going mm-hmm. to walk, then you mm-hmm. understand that, okay, the decor is going to, so you're going to have these poles, you're going to have this lighting from here, you're going to have this, you know, follow light that's going to come on, or you're going to have these lights that are going to be here at the Varmala area. So once you mm-hmm. understand all the aspects of the decor and the mm-hmm. stage and the pathway to leading to that venue,
mm-hmm.
you
mm-hmm.
can... you can actually imagine in your mind how mm-hmm. the flow is going to happen. And that enables you to start thinking, mm-hmm. okay, these are the kind of shots that I can bring about. And mm-hmm. these are the areas where I need to be placing myself or a team member to get mm-hmm. that right shot. So it does help in being there a couple of days prior to understanding.
Okay. Good. So that answers, that question is answered, Puneet. Yes, Divya also says nothing can.
That's one. That can green background something Puneet has mentioned. Can green background shots shoot with the help of editing look like a photo taken in a destination? But Puneet, yes, that's called chroma. I think we're quite aware and familiar with that. You can do chroma. Chroma has been used since donkey's years, literally. People have been using chroma way back with those other cameras as well, you know, the big handheld cameras. People have been using those chromas for a long time. Even in today's day and age where all these movies are shot, a lot of chroma effects are put into place there. So yes, you can use it, no doubt. The experience will be in a studio then. You'll have to set up the entire green background in a studio and do it in the studio and then recreate it on your editing. You know, the entire background needs to be changed there after that.
Okay. That answers very, very important for all of us. Divya also has asked us, what do you feel about taking pictures using remote access to the camera?
I'm sorry, could you repeat that again?
What do you feel about mm-hmm. taking the pictures using remote access to the camera? Of course, nothing is a replacement for a real photographer is what she says, but she still wants to understand. Should I repeat the question?
See, technically, it can be done. Technically, today, a lot can be done.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a feel factor. And
mm-hmm.
to give me a gun in my hand and say, shoot, I'll understand it. But if I've got to give the gun into somebody else's hand and tell him, okay, you know, I'm going to fire a remote tug, the feel factor is not going to be there. That feel is lost. It's all about feeling for me as a photographer. And mm-hmm. I think it's not that we can't do it. We can do it remotely. We can mm-hmm. set up a camera or two cameras or three cameras and stand maybe 20, 30 feet or maybe 100 feet away and yet mm-hmm. press the trigger as and when required. But mm-hmm. the feel factor of moving into different angles, having that camera in your hand and clicking the button on your own, you know, the shutter mm-hmm. on your own, is something that cannot be replaced. You can do a lot of gizmos in today's world. You can set up 50 cameras and then, you know, click it all at the same point of time. But you're not going to have the same. It's a different feel. So I would say we kill out the feel of being a photographer and get into the technical aspect. Then it's a total technicality only.
That's about it. Yes, now we can see and come back to the chat. Life of Rooney asks, how can we create a perfect picture? Technology with good equipment or photographers with imagination? Can you read that question? The last one
that's a brilliant question. That's a very, very good question. I think Vishakha, right? Yes, Vishakha. Vishakha, that's a fantastic question come about by you. You know, it is now in today's day and age, it's a mix of both. it is a complete mix of both. Its technology definitely is a great boon. It has really helped photographers to bring about recreating the colors and enhancing the colors of certain elements and being able to get a good photograph even better. It enhances that even much more. So it's, you definitely need a photographer to bring about that base, which is a good imagination, a good creativity in his mind to bring about the final product. So a photographer today needs to think about the final product while he's actually shooting a picture. So if I'm looking at a lovely clear, you know, sunset, which is at the background, I know at the end of it, I'm going to get a silhouette shot, I'm going to try out for that. Or if I need to get the faces right, I need to push light onto their faces. So the technical aspects on ground while you're shooting is a part of your recreation on the table, on your desk, on the computer, as the final edit. So you can use a mix of both to create your final brilliant picture that you want to. But the base has to be set with the photographer's imagination. There's no two ways about it. I hope that answers your question, Vishakha.
Yes, it does. It's very sensibly answered, I must say. So what do you have to say for the new coming brides who are waiting for their wonderful dream wedding to be happening after the lockdown or the situation opens up? Do you have any message you want to give to them?
I just hope they don't have to wear those masks on their face. Right. I just hope they don't have to. I'd love to see that smile on their face. Not that mask. You know, okay. It's going to be really difficult to imagine having to do this for a lifetime ahead of this, where people are going to be wearing masks. So I just hope and pray for all you lovely brides out there that, you know, things change and get back to a normal life.
Yes,
not the new normal that we're all talking about. Not the new normal that we're all talking about. It should get back to the old normal where we used to all meet, hug, talk, handshakes, you know, sit with each other close by and not having to worry about whether you're going to pass on any disease to me or I'm going to pass on any disease to you.
Like the real weddings. We look all waiting like and looking forward for the real weddings. Yeah, where we are dancing and eating and singing and hugging.
The party goes on, you know.
Yeah, till 7 a.m. in the morning.
Absolutely. And there's just nowhere we'll be close to that if we have to do, you know, I mean, eventually if you have to do it, you have to do it. But it's going to be nowhere close to the real thing. It's like, it's everything is going to be so much. It's like a dream that you're actually planned out your wedding in such a long time, probably in your head. You had some thought of you're doing a wedding in a certain way. And if you've got to do a complete opposite of that, where you have to just sit out there with your mask on and, you know, everyone around you is with a mask on. I feel a little unfortunate for times that that's got to happen. But yeah, if it's got to happen, we're going to be there yet to try and make a better experience out of it.
Yes. And what do you have to say to the photographers who have to get ready for this situation in future?
I think everybody's at risk if situations don't improve. So everybody needs to take care. It's not just friends and families. It's just everybody who's there out, whether it's the photographers, whether it's the decorators, whether it's the pandit, whether it's the bridegroom and her friends or the family. Everyone will have to be a little more careful about their interaction with people. And that is something which I'm very uncomfortable with in a wedding scenario. But we'll all have to do it. Eventually, if it boils down to that, we all will have to yet wear masks. So I wore a mask on the 20th of March, 2020, during my shoot in Delhi. I was doing a wedding here. And fortunately, we were able to complete the wedding at 5 in the morning. And we took out a flight and I sent the team back home the next morning on the 21st. But having to wear a mask and do a shoot was very, very uncomfortable. Not something that I would want to ever do again. It's uncomfortable. It gets in your way. Although today our cameras are mirrorless and you can watch on the screen and actually do the shoot directly that way. You don't need to put your eye right into the viewfinder. But it is definitely and uncomfortable and a compromise on mm-hmm. being a photographer and doing your work without that. Mm-hmm. So I would hope that we don't need to do that, but fingers crossed.
No, we all will go back to the lovely weddings that we've done in the past, and we will do it again. Yeah,
absolutely.
But still, just for some brides who are looking forward to getting married online or virtual wedding, do you want to suggest them how to keep their phone in, or what particular angle, or a laptop in a particular angle? Because they may be keeping their laptop and phones and getting married, but none of the shots are right. So
well, we've got today, thanks to technology, yes, we can do virtual weddings. We can also stream these virtual weddings online directly to their friends and family who are far away and not probably being able to make it, thanks to the air travel not being possible, mm-hmm. or restrictions or whatever, mm-hmm. So mm-hmm. the wedding can actually be taken virtually in a video format online instantaneously for people to see all across the world.
Yes.
So that is fantastic for all of us. That's fantastic for the, for the bride and her family and the groom as well, because they will be able to showcase their wedding instantaneously to people who can't make it.
Yeah.
Yes. But as far as angles and stuff are concerned, people being around, I would say try and be with the mask also. Try and be your normal self. Those 40, 50 people that are going to be a part of the wedding have, traveled and been there, come there especially for you. Make it more fun as much as you can. Enjoy that moment. It's never going to come back. It's a one-time, lifetime experience. And you need to, most importantly, is enjoy it, because if you enjoy it, it automatically shows in your photograph.
Photograph.
Well, so if you're enjoying it internally, you'll definitely get it. Somewhere you'll get some moments. But if you're thinking too much about what's happening, your mask, you're seeing people around you with the same, and you're like, this is something that's not what I thought about. Don't do that.
Yeah.
You'd rather wait it out for a couple of months and then have the big thing then otherwise.
Yes, yes. If you're not convinced.
Either you wait it out.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Either you wait it out and then have it, or if you're planning to have it during this situation, then you make sure that you are in the right spirit of enjoying it as well.
One more question that's popped up right now is, what lighting equipment should one use? Is ring light a good option for the virtual weddings or the...
For virtual weddings, Puneet, are we talking about virtual weddings here, or you're talking about being there practically?
Kaun jo upar? Adu door door
kaun kare? He's not answered that, but so, I thought the question just popped up when we were talking.
Right. So if he's talking about virtual wedding, yes, definitely you need some kind of lighting. It could be a ring light. It could be lights on. In the room, whatever available lights are there, if the lighting is good in the room itself, you're sorted. You need a ring light, I would say, only in areas where it's very, very low, the light, and you want to lift up the area where you need to shoot. With a ring light, you won't be able to light up the entire area, entire room. You'll be able to light up just one section of it. If you're there physically present and you want to use a ring light and move it around to where you're planning to shoot, that makes sense. But just to have it there placed in one side, or
makes no
two
sense.
Ring lights on two sides, may not serve the purpose depending on the lighting of the area. So you need to, again, physically see what the lighting of the area is. Does it need additional lighting? And if it does need additional lighting, does the ring light is going to be sufficient enough, or do you need to add on some more extra lighting? So, you can figure this out only when you've seen the location at that point of time in the evening or the night when the wedding is actually taking place. And based on that, you can make your judgment as to you do it. So adding another light or a ring light is going to be sufficient.
Okay. Good. So, we don't have any more questions here. I think we've answered most of them, all of them.
I think we've answered quite a lot of them. Absolutely. Okay. Absolutely.
Yes.
So, most importantly, I think what we need to, we were in fact talking the other day, and we were talking about how virtual weddings are going to change all our lives, literally. So, I definitely think it is, last 2 months has been a drastic change, and if things do come back to normal, I think it's going to be brilliant. It's going to enhance it even more further.
Even better.
People are waiting for it to get back to normal so they can have events. So mm-hmm. once a couple can actually look forward to having mm-hmm. a normal wedding, whether it be a destination or whether it be in their own city or in their own backyards, mm-hmm. I think the enhancement of just being open enough to have the same kind of fun and entertainment mm-hmm. is going to take the wedding to another level. And that's what I think I'm hoping for.
Yeah, and I think we'll value it even more, you know, because we'll value it more. We've never thought in our life that things like these could be taken away from us, like hugging
yes.
people and meeting people, going out for a cup of coffee. So I think we'll value every moment, every friendship, every person in our life. And so, God,
you know,
it's been a fantastic...
Gita, we used to always say, in fact, all of my friends and a lot of people who I used to meet earlier used to tell me, buddy, you've got into the right business. So I said, why? What do you mean by the right business? So that's a complete recession-free business. Photography for a wedding is a recession-free business. And I used to always think to myself, yes, I think what they're saying is probably right. But today when we look at it, and this situation... I think nothing is recession-proof.
Nothing
you know,
recession-proof.
We're all in a situation where everybody is wondering what's going to happen. And,
yeah.
and when people ask me what is going to happen, it's my guess is as good as yours. And
yeah.
even if you ask today, even if you ask the Prime Minister of India,
he
will probably not be able to give you a perfect answer stating that when this is going to end and when COVID is going to be out of the window.
That's
so
right.
we're all just hoping and praying and waiting for something to happen, a miracle
mm-hmm.
or... some good brains towards getting this out and
yes.
we should be able to take this forward back
yes.
into our real lives again.
We should be rocking back.
Absolutely. Okay. Hopefully soon.
So thank you so much, Parikshit. It's been lovely talking to you. Though
likewise,
we are so far. Yeah. It's nice. I would really, I'm really looking at the time when we sat in our office and had a cup of coffee and we
yes.
were looking forward to meet up in Delhi as well.
Absolutely. But
yeah.
we're going to take that up soon. I'm sure.
Yes,
sure.
So
hey,
thank
hi,
you
everyone.
So much.
Hi, everyone in the team. And thank you all for being there with us out here. And hope it was informative to all of you. And
mm-hmm.
Do share your comments at the end of the section on either our website
PK
or
Surya.
On on Insta. Just to let
yes.
us know if it helped you and how it's helped you.
Yes, do let us know. Thank you so much for a very enjoyable, knowledgeable and interactive chat, I must say. It's been a pleasure.
Likewise.
And I'll
Thank
see you.
You
soon.
Absolutely.
See you soon.
Thank
okay.
you. Likewise.
See
Take
you.
Care. See ya.
Okay,
Take care.
Bye. Take care.
Thank you.
See